Public Transportation Agency Safety Committee meeting to order. And just a brief introduction of myself. My name is Preston McLaughlin. I'm the senior transit planner here with PEG RTA, and I will be facilitating these safety committee meetings moving forward. We are now conducting our meeting on Zoom, and we have the meeting information on the screen. Please note that you are on mute, and to take yourself off mute, go to the bottom left of your screen. Thank you. Yeah, so I would now like to start with a roll call of our voting members. Starting with the RTA, we have Rio de Leon.
Here.
And with Total Ride National Express, we have Rebecca Silva.
Here.
Jason Tuttle. I don't think he's here now, but he might join later. Ted Herner.
Here.
Esteban Quevedo.
Here.
Estela Nunez.
Here.
All right. And with second generation, we have Kathy Hutton, who should be jumping on at some point, but isn't here now. Darren Rendon.
I don't believe he'll be in today.
Okay. Thanks, Brad. And then Bradley Reed, do you like to go by Brad or Bradley?
Brad is what I usually go by.
Okay. I'll make a note of that. Brad Reed.
Correct.
You can just stay here. Okay. That works. I believe we have a quorum and we can continue the meeting. I also, now that we've taken roll call officially, I'd like to request each member of the committee just give a brief introduction to themselves before we move on to the second agenda item. So in the same order as the roll call, I'll call your name, and then you can just give all of us just brief information on yourself and what your work is. So I'll just start with Rio again.
Hi, everyone. My name is Rio. I'm the Interim Transportation Mobility Manager here at RTA, and I work on Sun Shuttle.
Okay. Thanks, Rio. Rebecca Silva?
Hi, yes. I'm the Safety Manager, and I work for the Total Ride or Total Transit for the fixed routes and the SS Star routes for paratransit.
Okay. Thanks, Rebecca. Jason, I don't think is here. So we'll move on to Ted.
Yes, I'm a paratransit driver for Total Transit. I've been here about 3 years.
Okay. Thanks, Ted. Esteban?
Esteban Quevedo. I'm a maintenance technician.
Okay.
The company for 6 months.
Okay. Perfect. Yeah. Thanks, Esteban. Estela?
Hi. My name is Estela. I am a customer service representative, and I've been here for about 6 months, but I'm also a client. So I've been with the company itself for, I want to say over 15 years.
Wow. Nice. Nice to meet you, Estela. And then Kathy, I don't believe is here yet. So we'll move on to, and then Darren isn't attending. So Brad.
I'm Brad Reed. I'm the lead maintenance tech for second generation. I've been with Kathy almost 13 years now.
Nice. Okay. Great. Yeah. Thanks, Brad. So yeah, I just want to give everyone an opportunity to, since this is the first meeting, and you know, a lot of us haven't met each other, just give a little bit more information on ourselves. So that was helpful. So thank you for that. Now that we've had a brief introduction, we all know each other just a little bit better, and I'm sure we'll get to know each other a little better as we continue on and have future meetings. We can jump to agenda item number 2. Which is just I'll be providing information on the 2023 PTASP, which is, you know, if you don't know that abbreviation yet. It's the Public Transportation Agency Safety Plan. So that's the main focus of the safety committee, along with some additional, you know, responsibilities and duties. But reviewing and approving the safety plan is top of the list in terms of, you know, what we're hoping to accomplish with this committee. But just to give a little bit more background, this is the first year since 2020 that the RTA's PTASP has been updated. But moving forward, we're hoping to review and approve this plan on an annual basis, which has become a requirement of the Federal Transit Administration, or the FTA. This approval process is necessary each time we make any edits to the plan. And as we have also mentioned in previous emails that were sent out, you know, an additional requirement of the FTA and what I mentioned is this committee, and it needs to be composed of equal parts managerial staff and frontline workers. So that's why we have a nice mix of, you know, managers and people working, you know, drivers and maintenance techs and customer service representatives. So it's a nice, you know, mix of members, which is good because it's good to get everyone's perspective on how we can better improve the safety of our work environments and improve the safety for, you know, riders taking our services. And we all need to, you know, agree and to have this this plan fully approved each year. And just to give you some, you know, next steps in the approval process, once this committee has reviewed and approved the PTASP, it then goes on to the RTA's executive director. His name is Farhad Mogami, and he would be the next step in the review process. So he would review and approve the plan once we approve it. And then we then bring this approved plan to the RTA board, which is a collection of representatives from each jurisdiction in the county. And so they will also need to approve the plan. And then finally, once the RTA board approves, then we send this plan to ADOT. And they will eventually review it themselves, give us any feedback on any revisions or additional information that they're needing, and then they'll approve it. And so that's the whole approval process. It's pretty long and you know, has multiple steps, but this is the first step in that approval process. Is y'all's, you know, review and approval. So, yeah. Thank you for being part of this committee and you know, spending that time and energy looking over the PTASP and giving your input, because it is greatly appreciated and valued. So this year we've made a few significant changes to the last plan that was approved in 2020. Because the last PTASP that was generated in 2020 was actually generated by ADOT and not ourselves. We just provided additional information on our agency specifically and gave that to ADOT, and then they included it in the plan. But this plan also included information from 7 different transit agencies in Arizona that had a fleet of fewer than 100 vehicles. So the RTA was part of that, the, you know, that list of agencies. But moving forward, ADOT has instructed us to oversee the updates of this PTASP each year. So they're not going to be, you know, updating this plan like they had in the past. It's our responsibility now. And it's so every year, you know, we will make changes, we will bring it to y'all to review, and then go through that whole approval process that I just mentioned. And let's see what else in the PTASP. So what we did this year with, in terms of edits, we basically removed all information related to those other 6 transit agencies, and made this PTASP specific to the RTA and what the RTA does in terms of, you know, safety protocols. So, you know, we went through and just deleted all of that information that, that doesn't apply to us or the RTA or any of y'all. And then the other, you know, significant changes we made came from a list of action items that ADOT provided us in 2020 with the last PTASP, just showing us the sections of the plan that needed additional information for the next PTASP, which is this one. And so there were five separate sections where they requested additional information. And that's what I had originally in my email that I sent out a little over a week ago, to y'all was, you know, it was different parts of the plan. And just to give a refresher, those five sections were requirement number 7, which was the emergency management program, requirement number 8, which is record keeping, element 11, which is rules compliance, element 13, which is the procurement process, and then element 14, which is competencies and training. So within those five sections, ADOT was requesting more information. So, sorry, I'm going to grab some water. Those were the sections where we needed to, you know, add that additional information. And so that's what we did this year. Just included some additional paragraphs that better explained our processes for each of those sections. And so hopefully that's enough for ADOT to, you know, to please ADOT and for them to approve the plan. And if not, they'll let us know. And then we can make further revisions if needed. I didn't receive any suggested edits or revisions from any of the members of this committee, which, you know, so with that information, I'll assume that everyone feels that this plan is sufficient and does not lack any crucial information, which is good. It makes, I guess, life a little bit easier for everybody. However, I did want to focus our attention on element number 11, which is the rules compliance section of the PTASP. I added some additional information recently that wasn't included in the PTASP PDF that I sent out a week ago. And I wanted you to be aware of this, these changes and these new additions before we all approve the plan at the end of this meeting. So I'm going to share my screen and show you exactly, you know, the information I added. And please feel free to jump in and let me know if it's accurate or if there's any additional information you would like me to include in this section. And then once we review just this one section and everyone agrees that, you know, no additional edits are needed, then we can proceed with the approval process of this plan. So let me share my screen real fast. Okay. Let me know if you can see the my screen and you'll see rules compliance process. Is everyone able to see this?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Got it. Perfect. Thank you. So originally it was just, and what you saw in the PDF that I sent was just this one sentence. The RTA has adopted techniques for ensuring rules compliance by operations, maintenance personnel. Evidence of compliance checks is provided through write check forms from the various providers, which would be all. So I added this additional information here. So I just wanted to walk through that. And just to give you some background information. So here's element number 11, rules compliance. And these are the requirements needed from our end to, you know, be within compliance with the FTA. And it breaks it down here of what we need to do and what information they need. So to monitor our system for compliance for operations and maintenance, we also need to monitor and identify any safety risk mitigations that are not efficient and that can be improved upon. And then conduct any investigations of safety events to identify any issues. And then just monitor information reported through, you know, internal safety systems. So that's kind of what I focused on when I added this additional information. I believe based on my conversations with Rebecca that, you know, and I assume this is the case with second generation, that this information is accurate, but let me know if it's not. So what I added was that designated safety representatives. So in this case, it's going to be Rebecca for Total Ride National Express. And then for second generation, who is the designated safety representative? Or is there one?
I believe it's Darren Rendon.
Okay. So in this case, Darren would be the other individual, you know, that this applies to, that they will monitor the safety procedures relevant to each agency and ensure that these rules are being properly followed. So I just include this information that we do have safety representatives for both Total Ride and second generation that, you know, it's their job to make sure that all safety related rules are being followed. And then also I included that this safety committee, the PTAS safety committee, will review and monitor work operations to ensure that there are no inefficiencies in these processes when needed. So, and if there are inefficiencies, representative members of this committee will bring these inefficiencies to the safety committee for improvements. So what this means is that, you know, if anyone notices any unsafe working conditions or, you know, safety rules that maybe could be improved upon, that they bring this to the safety committee for review and discussion. And then eventually we can, you know, figure out a strategy to improve those, you know, those rules or, you know, inefficiencies. So that's what that information is. And then I include that all safety related events and incidents will be investigated by the designated safety representatives. So again, that's Rebecca and the individual from second generation, to better understand what occurred and ensure that the same incidents are not repeated, and that these events, these, I guess I'll put these safety related events will also be discussed and reviewed by the RTA representatives for full transparency. So I'm hoping that whenever there is a safety event or, you know, an incident, that safety related incident that occurs, maybe incident, it's a better word. When any safety related incident occurs at either Total Ride or second gen, that it's brought to our attention as well, Rio and myself, just so we can be in the loop as well. So hopefully all this information is accurate, makes sense. Rio, it looks like you had a question. Oh, it looks like you're muted.
I'd like to make a friendly amendment to the section that says the PTAS Safety Committee. In order to maintain consistency across naming conventions, can we change that to Transit Safety Committee?
Sure. Yeah, I don't see an issue with that. And anyone else, let me know if they do, and we can discuss it. But I'll change that to Transit if everyone else is okay with that. Okay. So yeah, that's what I included. That's what's different compared to the last PDF that was sent out to y'all. Let me know, is everyone okay with this change? And if not, you know, you can speak up and include, or I guess verbalize any changes you'd like to see made in this section.
I'm okay. It's Rebecca.
Okay. Great. Okay. Yeah, so that is the only edit that I've made since sending everyone else the PDF of the PTAF. So everything else should be the same and as to what you saw a week ago. So I will leave this and include this section in the PTAF that I sent to Farhad whenever we approve this plan. So I'm going to stop sharing my screen because that was the only section I wanted to really focus on a little bit more on. So great. All right. Thank you, everybody, for reviewing that and making sure that everything made sense in that section that I added. So like I mentioned, I didn't receive any other comments or suggestions for changes for this PTASP. So I'll go ahead and assume that everyone is okay and agrees with the current PTASP and feels like it's sufficient. And if that's the case, I wanted to provide one more opportunity for anyone to make any comments on this plan before we move to a motion to approve the plan. So I'll just open the floor to anyone who may have any comments or suggestions that they want to discuss further.
Preston, did you get any, or Enrio, I've been sick and out a bit this month. From Amy, did you see any of those that came through?
For?
On the PTAS, any suggestions?
Amy,
she's the one, our safety director for National Express.
No, I mean, I haven't.
Got forwarded to you?
No, I haven't received any emails from Amy or anyone else.
Or from Roger. Okay, because you remember when we first went over, you were asking me to look over like Section 11 and stuff. And I didn't know if she had some suggestions.
Well, I only sent these the PTAS to just our committee members.
Okay.
Yeah, and Amy is not part of that committee.
Oh, right, because she's on that other stuff, huh?
Of this committee, yeah. Okay. So, yeah, if were there comments, edits that were made that you wanted to see included in this plan?
Not that I can see, because it's not lined out the way she had put some suggestions to me.
Okay.
I don't see it. I don't see a change.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. And I mean, you can share, I guess, for future plans and updates. Okay. You know, I am only, I guess, expecting comments from committee members, but that doesn't mean that you can't get input from people, I guess, outside the committee to help you review. But
our safety director representing National Express. So I just ran some stuff through her to make sure I was on task. Since this is my first time being part of a committee.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wanted to make sure I did not overstep for National Express and make sure I was in compliance.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense. But yeah, I mean, if you've reviewed it, and you feel like it looks good and there's no glaring issues, then, I think that should be sufficient for this update.
Okay. So then it's good to go on my end.
Okay. So yeah, if that's the case, did anyone else have any information or comments they wanted to provide related to this plan? Okay. If not, then I would now like to proceed with the process for having the committee approve this plan, the PTASP. I wanted to provide a little bit more information on this process of approval. So this will work by having any member of this committee make a motion to have the plan approved by this subcommittee. So you can just say, I would like to make a motion to have this plan approved. I can't do this because I'm the, I'm facilitating the meeting. I'm the chair of this committee, but someone else will need to just make a motion to approve this plan within our committee, so we can then bring it to Farhad for his approval. And then once one individual, a voting member of this committee makes a motion, a separate person will need to second the motion. And all I need to do for that is just say, I second this motion if you believe that this plan should be approved. And then I will go ahead and ask for a vote from each of the members of this committee by just saying all in favor of this motion, say aye. And if you do believe that, you know, if you would like this plan to be approved, you just say aye. If you don't, I will also say all opposed to this motion, say nay. And then you can say nay, and then that will be an indication that you don't approve of the motion. And additionally, I will ask if anyone is wanting to abstain from this vote. So if you don't want to vote at all, you just let us know that you abstain from the vote. And that's, you know, neither a yes or no. And a simple majority of members is needed to approve the motion. So if, you know, however many voting people are here today, I don't remember the exact amount, 7 or 8 people. I guess if there are 8 people, then 5 of us need to vote yes, and then the motion will be passed. So that's the process. Were there any questions about how this is done? Okay. If not, then if there are no additional questions, I'd like to request a motion be made to approve the 2023 PTASP to bring to the RTA's executive director for his approval. So I guess anyone can make that motion.
I, Rebecca, motion for us to accept this approval, correct?
Okay, great. Yeah, that's perfect. Thanks, Rebecca. Can I get a second to this motion?
Jason will second the motion.
Okay. Thank you. So all in favor of this motion, say aye.
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 Okay, and all opposed, say nay. All right, and does anyone wish to abstain from voting? Okay, so it appears that the vote is unanimous and the PTASP will now be approved to the RTA's executive director for approval. So thank you for that. So now we can move on to agenda item number 3. And this is where Rhea will give a brief presentation on what the future holds for this committee and future agenda items that we'll need to discuss later on at our next Transit Safety Committee meetings. So I'll pass it over to Rhea.
Howdy, y'all. Great to be with you. And I'm really excited about sharing with you what we're going to be doing in the future regarding the new Transit Safety Committee. We've got a big task, but we're going to break it up into manageable chunks so that we can all get the system as best as it possibly can be when regarding safety. So I want to start by bringing up the background again, just some basic building blocks to help understand what we're working with. Bipartisan infrastructure law passed last year, as you probably heard, including all the requirements for the PTASP that we just undertook. It requires a select committee. That means that the federal government saw it fit to have both management and frontline workers contribute. This makes sense in the grand scheme of things, because who knows what is best for our riders, and who knows what's best to help get people from A to B. It's not just us in management. We need help from seeing things on the ground. Okay, so these are the federal requirements of the safety committee. Number one, the thing that we just did, you were all here for it, so I don't need to go through it again. Number two, we're going to identify and recommend mitigations and strategies to reduce the likelihood and severity of consequences identified through the agency safety risk assessment. Three, we'll identify mitigations or strategies that may be ineffective, inappropriate, or were not implemented as intended. And 4, identify safety deficiencies for purposes of continuous improvement. The reason why I bring this up is because in the future, we'll be meeting, I think we agreed quarterly, to go over some of these items together. And the goals for the next meeting are to focus on item number four, identifying the deficiencies of the system as it exists right now. And so what I'm asking y'all to bring to the table next time we meet in the next quarter is some things that we could be doing better. This could be in the public transit agency safety plan. It could be things that are happening in your day-to-day operations of Sun Shuttle, both in Tucson and in Ajo. But ultimately, we want to be improving the safety continuously. So that's our big ask for you next time. Come with ideas, come with, and come ready to brainstorm. That's the long and short of things. So with that, do y'all have any questions about what this committee is going to be doing in the future and how we can help best support you in your process of coming up with things to improve?
You're good. No questions on our part.
All right. I'll hold it here. Hold the space a little bit longer. Any questions? All right. Hearing none. I want to thank you all again for helping us out with this kind of monumental task.
Great. Yeah. Thanks, Rio, for providing that additional information. Yeah. Excited to see how we can improve, you know, all of the safety rules and procedures and processes that we've had. See if where we can, you know, better equip ourselves to handle any safety related incidents in the future. So I'm excited for our next meeting and to brainstorm and, you know, figure out, you know, if there's any deficiencies and how we can improve on those. So now we are now at item number 4, which is adjournment of the meeting. So it was a pretty painless meeting, only, you know, 38-40 minutes. That's not bad. Especially for our first meeting, I was actually expecting a few more hiccups and issues, but I think things went pretty well. So thank you all for making this a quick and painless process. So before we adjourn, are there any additional announcements or comments anyone would like to make? Okay. If not, thank you for participating, and we will reach out to you before our next scheduled meeting. Probably, you know, a month before our next scheduled meeting is you know, when I would expect us to ask y'all, you know, not ask y'all, but inform y'all on when we'll be having that meeting and what y'all will need to bring to the table, like Rio mentioned, in terms of, you know, safety improvements within each of y'all's respective agencies, organizations. So with that, have a good rest of your day. And yeah, thank you again for your work on this. And I'll talk to you at some point in the near future.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.